never close his composure. Even though I hold the weight of the whole world on my shoulders, I ain't never supposed to show it. My crew ain't supposed to know it. Even if it means going toe-to-toe with the Benzino, it don't matter. I never drag him in battles that I can handle unless I absolutely have to. I'm supposed to set an example. I need to be the leader. My crew looks for me to guide him. But something never does pop off. I'm supposed to be beside him. That job and I tried to squash it. It was too late to stop it. There's a certain line you just don't cross, and he crossed it. I heard him say Haley's name on a song and I just lost it. It was crazy, this f***ing wavy on some Jay-Z and Nas. And even though the battle was won, I feel like we lost it. I spent so much energy on it, honestly I'm exhausted. And I'm so caught in it, I almost feel I'm the one who caused it. This ain't what I'm in hip-hop for, it's not why I got in it. That was never my object, for someone to get killed. Why would I wanna destroy something I helped build? That wasn't my intentions were good. I went through my whole career without ever mentioning to Ganesh, just out of respect for not running my mouth and talking about something that I knew nothing about. Frustrates told me stay out. This just wasn't my beef, so I did. I just fell back, watched and gritted my teeth while he's all over TV. Now I'm talking to a man who literally saved my life. Like, it, I understand this is business, and this here just isn't none of my business. But still knowing that it could pop off at any minute. To be a time when you could just say a rhyme and wouldn't have to worry about one of your people dying. But now it's elevated, cause once you put someone's kids in it, it just gets escalated. It ain't just words no more, is it? It's a different ballgame. You call names and you ain't just rapping. We actually tried to stop the 50 and Javi from happening. Me and Dre had sat with him, kicked it and had a chat with him and asked him not to start it. He wasn't gonna go after him until Josh started gabbing in magazines how we stabbed him. If it be smashing, mash on him, let him have it. Meanwhile, my attention's pulled in another direction. Some receptionist at the source who answers phone to this desk has an obsession for me and thinks that I'll be his resurrection. Tries to blow the dust off his mic and make a new record. But now he's f***ed the game up, cause one of the ways I came up was through that publication, the same one that made me famous. Now the owner of it has got a grudge against me for nothing. If that other sucker could get it too. But I'm so busy being pissed off, I don't stop to think that we just inherited 50's beef with Murder, Inc. And he's inherited mine, which is fine. Ain't like either of us mine. We still have soldiers that's on the front line. He's willing to die for us as soon as we give the orders. Never to extort us, strictly to show they support us. Or maybe shout them out in a rap or up in a chorus to show them we love them back and let them know how important it is to have Runyon Avenue soldiers up in our corners. The loyalty to us is worth more than any award is. But I ain't trying to have none of my people heard or murdered. It ain't worth it. I can't think of a perfect way to word it. Than to just say that I love y'all too much to see the verdict. I walk away from it all before I let it go any further. But don't get it twisted. It's not a plea that I'm copping. I'm just willing to be the bigger man if y'all can quit popping off at your jaws with a knocking. Cause frankly, I'm sick of talking. I'm not gonna let someone else's coffin rest on my conscience.